So I'm trying really hard to film so much of this whole process of moving, but it's just getting really stressful. Wednesday and I wanted to bring my camera, but the battery is pretty much dying. It's dying for good, not just dying in general, like I could charge it. And even then I wouldn't really have much time to charge it if it was just a regular die. But we have batteries on the way and they should be here today, but they probably won't arrive until like 2 this afternoon. So it'd be, you know, too late for, because I want to go shopping now and get it done with, because I got to come back and pick up this place. I have a lot of laundry to deal with, and then I want to put up the last like vlog I have. It's huge, so it's going to be a really long one, but it's a lot of fun little things in it, so I'm hoping that you'll enjoy that. And yeah, it's been kind of crazy. My car wouldn't start yesterday, so I had to get a boost from AAA. If you know what that is, it's like a service that you can get with a membership, and they'll come and help you with roadside assistance, or if you're home and your battery won't start in this freezing cold because it's been like negative, you know, something negative. It's been zero and then negative like 15, negative 20. It's been pretty cold lately, so there's a lot of ice, and a lot of people's cars get drained, their batteries get drained and things get frozen. It's pretty frustrating, but my car needs to go into the garage next Tuesday, so that will be good. But it's also frustrating because that following weekend we're moving. Too many things close together that need to be paid for and done. And so we're gonna go food shopping. I'm gonna try to film on my phone because that's all I have, but I don't have a lot of memory because I have so much stuff on my phone. I need to get a bigger memory stick, and then that way I will have room for filming and whatnot. I just don't like the audio quality on my phone. That's the only thing that bugs me. So this guy's playing with Play-Doh. I got him yesterday because we were supposed to go shopping yesterday, but my car was acting funny, so I didn't want to risk it, even though I did get a boost. It's better to let it run a little bit. I went down to the store, got on Play-Doh, got gas just to help with that whole situation, and then I let it run last night too for like 20 minutes. So we'll see how it does now, but yeah, that's how things are going. Oh, another thing, he got sick again. I don't know if I filmed that before. If I did, then I'll probably cut this out. But if he got really sick, he got like a virus thing, so we ended up being here like most of the weekend. It was snowy anyway and whatnot, but it was a nice chill weekend. But I felt bad because he was sick and, you know, fevers and whatnot. Then one of the nights the cats knocked our TV over and busted it. We're still able to watch it somewhat as far as like him watching it. It would bug me if I was trying to really watch a good movie on it, but the whole top of it is like messed up and shattered inside, not the outside because it's like plastic, but the inside of it. So it's really frustrating. My husband's not too worried because he was thinking about getting a bigger TV anyway, but then we would have had that as a second TV for like our bedroom or, you know, whatever. So it's just frustrating because that's a lot of money down the drain. But that's what's been happening. So I'm gonna go start my car and see if it starts. Go, let's see if it starts. That's not the battery, so that's good. That is just the fuel need to go through my fuel lines because they need to be repaired. So so it should start today and be okay with the battery, so that's good. But almost there. I can't wait to get my fuel lines fixed. It's so frustrating. Almost there. Let me just skip it. Second. Almost there. Alright. There we go. Yay! It almost was gonna stall. It acted funny. Alright, let's put some heat on. There. Let's go get the baby. Snowing again. We're gonna have a lot of snow this winter. I have a good feeling just because it's already been snowy and everything. It looks really pretty when it's all over the trees though, I will say that, but it's a pain to drive in and deal with as far as that, and then the freezing and everything. But we're up at 1, and then he didn't go back to sleep until like almost 6 something, and then I passed out and we slept until like 11 or 10 something, I can't remember. And then now we're up. Pretty tired. I've had already a cup of coffee before I fell asleep this morning at 6 something, and then I'm having a second cup, so I don't think I'll go any more than that because I'm feeling kind of blah. But just having coffee and cleaning up, and I really want to rest, but then I really want to pack because we only have a week before we move. So I would really like to get a lot more packing done, but it's just like I have the motivation and I want to get it done, and I'm excited about just packing and getting things, like, you know, all together. But when I actually think about the whole process, I'm like, I might do a little bit later though. I think I just need to chill and relax because where my sleep is all kind of messed up and broken up. And I got a little more boxes. I'm guessing that's how much I've had before. No, I had a little bit more. So I still have some boxes to go. Whoops, right there. And maybe I can just do a little bit. I'm just really, really tired, but I really should do something at least. I also have this lovely pile of laundry to do, so I'll probably tackle that right now while I chill. And I have some more in there. It's pretty bad. Once I get busy with stuff like this, with moving and everything, things lack. But whatever, it'll be better once we're all fine in the other house and things are set. No, you can't go on roads. There's a car coming. It's Monday. I feel like I need to change the beginning of each day. But yeah, it's Monday and we have 4 days till we move, which is crazy. But we're trying to get things really buckle down and make sure everything's packed at least before Thursday and Friday, so that way just things can be done. And we can concentrate on like little cleaning stuff and, you know, different things like that. So that way we're not so stressed out about it. And then people can just come in, take the boxes, go, and then we can come back and do little touch-up cleanings and whatnot. Because when we moved last time, I was not fully ready. I mean, I had a 3-month-old, which was hard because you're breastfeeding them every like 1 to 2 hours. And then just anything else that I have to do, all the diaper changes and everything. So it's a little better now because he can run around and play and have snacks and watch movies. And, you know, he doesn't go to the bathroom as much. So it's like, you know, at the most like 4 diapers a day. So it's not that bad. Right? Only 4 diapers? Can you say hi?
Hi.
Cars.
Ah.
So this is what we have so far for some of the boxes. And then in here, it's pretty, it's getting cleared out. I still need to put my two bundles of clothes in bags like that. It's just easier to do that. Those are all cleaned out. All drawers are cleaned out. I have stuff there. Those are cleaned out for the most, I think. I had to double check, but I'm pretty sure they're cleaned out too. Anything that was on the walls are gone. This guy is crazy boy. I think pretty much everything underneath the bed is taken out except for a massager thing that goes in a chair. I'm just trying to think of what else. I still need to like worry about that thing a little bit. That had movies in it, and that's out. My husband already took off all the guitars and put away some of his equipment. There's guitars over there. Yeah, is it the movie? And then our broken TV. So disappointed by that. And if I didn't mention it, I don't even know if I mentioned it, but yeah, the cats made the TV fall over because they fell through the crack right here. That crack right there. I had to put a box there so they wouldn't fall again, just to salvage the TV until we get a new one. But yeah, it's like all smashed. It's so frustrating. It's one thing that makes me not like having cats, because they can climb things and then just make messes. I know dogs can chew things, but I don't know. I feel like sometimes they're not as bad as cats. So I have that. We ended up getting this coat rack. It's sometimes easier to have like a coat rack out, and then when you have people over, you have a few of your coats, but everyone else can like put their coats on here when they come visit. And then we're gonna have like, in the new house, we'll have like a little, one of those plastic things for shoes and whatnot, just to make it nicer, because he's gonna be painting the entryway floor, because right now it's white. It's really weird. But he's gonna paint like a really dark brown, which will match the rest of the house as far as like the natural wood floors. So it'll go really well with that. But he's gonna be painting Wednesday, Thursday, or prepping and then painting Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, which is really cool because we got to pick the colors. We had to stay neutral, but we're still really happy because we're not crazy color people. We don't like dark walls or any crazy colors. So the colors we picked are very neutral. Actually, I have color swatches and they might come out on camera. I'm not sure. Let's see if I can find them. All right. So hopefully they come out true. I don't know if they are going to. So this is tea light. It's coming out lighter than, it's even, oh yeah, that's better. So that's tea light. It's kind of like a, kind of like what you would think, like when you lit a tea light and the coloring that comes off, it's kind of like soft light. So that's that. We have this for the trim. I really wish I could show you the full color. So it's like an off-white color, so it goes good with that. It's gonna block the light. There we go. And then this is gonna be the entryway floor and the office floor. It looks black here, but it's actually just like a dark brown. And then, yeah, so that's the colors that we picked. The other color we picked was for the bathroom and for the office walls. We just wanted kind of like a little bit of a contrast instead of all that tea light color. It's gonna be like a, it's called Moonburst, I think. But it's a really soft blue, like a really soft blue, but it has a hint of gray in it, so it's not like too blue, it's not like sky blue or anything. It has like a hint of gray, so it just like mutes it a little bit. Are we going to a new house? Are you gonna have a new room? We're gonna have a fireplace, and we're gonna live next to a goat and a sheep and chickens, right? And we're gonna be able to go for walks. Huh? All your toys. What do you have to say? You tell me a secret?
A dog.
Is that a dog?
Yeah. Yeah.
What else? Who else can you tell me?
Monster truck.
Monster truck. Is that what Grammy got you? Monster truck.
And Frank.
Frank.
Me and her dad want me Frank. Me and her Jason. And me and her sister.
Frank was chasing Mater. Yeah.
And Gaggy Kim is Chow.
Chow, wow.
Yeah, Gaggy Kim is on the road.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's on in the corner. And this is Gaggy Kim Rex.
Whoa. Oh, who's that down there?
It's Single.
Who's that?
It's Single.
Huh?
Oh, it's Single.
Oh.
Oh, it's Single.
Who's this? Who's that?
Oh, I find Sarge.
Sarge?
Sarge. They call that.
Who's the other one?
Other one's Luigi.
Yeah.
That's so cute. Godzilla. And Dark.
Green.
Green. And brown.
Yeah, brown.
And red.
Yeah.
Yeah. And big red.
Big red.
And not big red.
Who is he?
He is red.
Who's he?
He's Mac.
He's Mac.
He's on the tongue. On
He's
the
tongue. Got a tongue. Silly Mac.
And this one, Mac.
Dinoco truck.
Reckon.
What color?
Color is this.
Good job.
And now red. And this is how.
Where's Guido? Is Guido over there with your slippers?
No. He's over here in the garage.
Oh, in the box.
This one.
But where's Guido?
Here.
Yeah, we don't have Guido.
Here. Underneath.
He's not underneath, no. Oh, we got stuck. Good job. Whoops. Uh-oh. Mommy needs some water. I'm dehydrated. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're happy and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're happy and you know it, clap your hands. If you're cute and you know it, give a smile. If you're cute and you know it, give a smile. If you're cute and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're cute and you know it, give a smile. If you're angry and you know it, stomp those feet. Stand up. Stomp your feet. If you're angry and you know it, stomp your feet. Boom, boom. If you're angry and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're angry and you know it, stomp those feet. Boom, boom. If you're silly and you know it, wiggle, wiggle. If you're silly and you know it, wiggle, wiggle.
Wiggle, wiggle.
If you're silly and you know it, and you really want to show it. If you're silly and you know it, wiggle, wiggle.
Wiggle, wiggle.
You're so cute, buddy. I love you. I love you. Hello. I love you. I love you. Say it. Oh, thank you. made some pasta. Just waiting on some bread. I just put some butter on. It had like big chunks of garlic. It's like a ciabatta bread. We tried to make things so it's not so stressful, but no matter what, things happen. So the first thing is Riker's sick again, and I took him to the doctors yesterday, but they said there's nothing wrong with him except for he could have like just a cold virus thing again. And I know he's at the age where he can get molars. So there's that possibility, but he keeps getting some fevers and things like that, and he's just really like unwell. And the worst of it was last night, I think, and then this morning, because he was up at like 11 something, and then he went down around almost 3 finally, and then he was up at 9 or almost 9. I let him sleep as long as he would sleep. I let him sleep while I got ready and everything, even though I'm so tired because I've only had like 3 hours of sleep. But we have so much to do at that other place. My husband's painting it and everything, and there's a lot of cleaning to be done, because the people who lived there before are friends. The dump was closed the day that they had, because we only have 3 days to go to the dump. We have Sunday and Saturday, which is 8 to 3. And then you have Wednesday, which is today, 2 to 4:30. And they had to leave early this morning. And they were closed for Christmas on Saturday. I mean Sunday. So they couldn't take their trash. So we have a lot of, we probably have like 3 truckloads of trash and furniture and stuff that there was originally at the house that we don't want, that can be thrown out. So there's just a lot of stuff that needs to be to the dump, so I need to do a few trips with my car, and then probably have to wait until Saturday and have someone help us with the rest, because there's no way half of that can fit in my car. Even though I have a hatchback, it's still, you know, I wouldn't have room. And so since this guy's sick, my mom was supposed to come later on today and help clean and things like that, but because he's sick, she's coming early, which I feel so terrible. I feel so bad. I know I shouldn't, because she, you know, is happy to help. She's happy to like be able to stay here with him and take care of him. But I just feel really bad that I had to have her come earlier. And, because she already had some stuff that she had to do this morning and just things like that. I just feel really bad, but I know she'll tell me not to. But it's just like we're over our heads in stuff we have to do to move. And this is probably like the worst we've had as far as moving, because the other apartment we had, we could just, like, my husband moved in first, and then when we got married, I moved in, and there was no issue as far as, like, cleaning or having to do anything. But because we're painting and all that stuff, and because they didn't have the trash to be able to take that out, we just have a lot of that stuff to do. And then there's gonna be a lot of cleanup as far as after painting and everything, so we have that whole house to clean, trash to get rid of, finish. He's gonna do all the painting and, you know, get trim. You have to, right now he's scraping all the old paint off, then paint, and then plus stuff here. Like, I still have to pack the rest of our stuff. It's not a lot, but I still have to pack the rest of our stuff. That's what I have so far with some stuff, and then I have some stuff there, so not too bad. But yeah, it's just like there's a lot to do. I'm gonna go over there and clean the house. I might show some of it, but then you can kind of see maybe a before and after, so maybe we'll see. But I gotta change the battery because it's dying. Sick. You feel sick? I have my coffee waiting for my mom. I needed coffee. I'm actually really hungry. I just don't really feel like eating. And then I gotta see if this guy will eat something. I gotta buy him some more popsicles. There's these popsicles that are fruit and veggie, and they're pretty, for the most part, pretty healthy, and he really likes them, and that's what he pretty much ate yesterday, was popsicles, and he had a little bit of crackers, I think, and a little bit of cereal, but other than that, that's all he ate, so it stresses me out. I'm so stressed, guys. I'm so stressed. I hate being stressed. I'm not that type. I'm a bubbly, happy person most of the time, but it's like when there's so much happening and you want to just be like settled in your place and be happy, but when you're like here and there and everywhere, it's really stressful. Ready? Here comes Grammy. Listen. Here she is.
Hi, Grammy.
Hi.
How's he doing?
So there's a lot of stuff still in the way, but this is the kind of before, like with all the sanded trim and everything. This is the little side room. So this room has been sanded. There's like a closet there. Shelf there, the fireplace. This is the entryway. That's gonna be fixed and the floors will be painted. And then there's this room, which looks like that. It's like the summer room. Some of that stuff needs to come out though. And then that's this is the kitchen. This is the bathroom, so that's the tub, and that needs to be cleaned. So, and there's a small toilet here, but that needs to be cleaned. And then this is the dining room. A little, like, shelving hatch there. And this is like another entryway, but we're not using that door. And then the stairs. Up the stairs, it looks like this. You go in here, this is Riker's room, but it needs to be stupid light. So this is, that needs to be like on. So here's this little area, this room. And then that's his closet, which looks really creepy right now. This is the bathroom, the second bathroom upstairs, which is pretty, oops. Oh yeah, it's a light. This is that. And then this is the big bath bedroom, but I can't find the light. I don't know if there is a light in here. It gets stressed. So you can kind of get a gist of it, even though it's dark. Yeah, that's it so far, and you can see after we paint and decorate. Good morning, guys. So, I am so exhausted. So Riker, I don't know if I mentioned it yesterday, I think I did. He's really sick. He has like a really bad cold. Like it's going in his lungs, and last night was terrible. His throat hurts and everything, so he would like, I can't get a lot of his goop out of his nose because he doesn't like to blow his nose, and to suck it out is like really hard. I did the best I could while he was like out. He fell asleep a couple times and I was able to suck a little bit out. Other than that, I can't get it out, and so it's just draining, and so his throat hurts, and then it would make him cough. And so like every maybe 20-30 minutes he would wake up and just cough and just be like, oh mama. And so basically I didn't fall asleep until almost 3 o'clock in the morning, and he was pretty like bad off. I just had him lay on me most of the time, and then finally he kept falling off the couch because he just kept moving so much. And so I put him like beside me so he wouldn't fall off, but then he just kept moving and moving, and so I figured I'll put him in his bed. He can't fall off his bed because it's, you know, a crib. And maybe he'll sleep okay. If not, then it's fine. I'll go in there with him or bring him back out or whatever. But I put him in there, and he was out from 3 o'clock till 8 something. Yeah. So that's good. I'm glad that he was able to sleep because it was so hard. And I tried to give him Tylenol because he had a fever, and I only got part of it in because the rest of it he kind of spit out. And he had some cold medicine in him, but it wasn't like a ton. So it's just like, I was so stressed like last night. I wanted to cry. I want to cry now just because I'm like, I'm exhausted. And there's like so much to do at the new house. Like, it was, there's so much stuff there that needed to be thrown away. And I had to go to the dump like a million times to get rid of a lot of stuff. And then there's just a lot of cleaning. My husband's trying to paint and make it look good. And there's just so much to do. There's just a lot to do. And then with a sick kid, it just makes it really stressful. So last night I was ready to just blow and start bawling. But it's a new day. He woke up like looking fine. He doesn't seem to have a fever. He's scratchy. He has a scratchy little voice, but other than that, he seems okay. I was gonna take him to the doctor's today, but he seems okay. He seems like he might like not be so bad. I'm trying to carry like 1,000 things with the camera. I'll come back for my coffee. So we will see. How you feeling, buddy?
Yes.
That's what Grammy got you, huh?
Open it.
You wanna open it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
There you go. Now open the Olaf. Ready? Oh, can you open it? Just, oh, okay. There, now try it. Oh, there you go.
No.
Okay. Oh, much better right now, and I hope he stays like that. I'm just gonna keep make sure he gets his medicine in him and whatnot. But yeah, I tried to make sure that even though I was giving him Tylenol, that I didn't give it so much to him because I know it is important for them to have a fever. Like for a little bit, just because fever can be a good thing. It can kill off infection, so it's good to like let them have a little fever. But then once it got a bit too high, that's when I gave him some more Tylenol. But he was so warm that I didn't have covers on him. I didn't have anything like on him besides his PJs. I turned the heat way down, and I figured I could just cover up. My husband's covered up, and I tried to make it so it wasn't so hot in here. We need a humidifier. We almost thought we had one, but at the new house, but it wasn't there. You okay, buddy? You okay? I know, honey. I'm sorry. You feel terrible. You can go lay down, honey. We need to get some of that boogies out of your nose.
Yeah. Get the other nose.
Yeah. The other thing I did is I made a little bit of like my own Vicks with coconut oil, mint oil, or peppermint oil, and a little bit of lavender just to help like loosen anything and help him breathe good. And it seemed, every time I put that on, it seemed to help him for a little while. It's so messy.
Hey, got it.
Thank you. So it's the last day of the week. Well, besides Saturday, but I was to say Friday is. And more stuff has happened so far, and I'm trying really hard not to lose it. I am so sorry this vlog is gonna be so depressing, but hey, it's reality, it's what happens in real life. Real life is not all, you know, rainbows and, you know, wonderful things all the time. Things happen and frustrating things happen. So Riker's feeling a bit better, actually a lot better, which is a huge relief. He just has it in his chest and his nose still, and he's all hoarse. But Riker, can you say something?
Yeah.
Say hi.
Hi.
Say I was sick.
I was sick.
Yeah.
And juice.
Yeah, yummy juice. Drink up. So he's feeling better, which is good, but still, like, my husband's calling me. Hello? So, my husband's already at the, I think Rocket's freaking out. Rocket, come on, honey. Come on. In. Come on. Right now. It's a strange cat. So actually, I should show you guys the snow really quick while I'm at the door. So basically, this is the snow. It's almost 2 feet, or probably 2 feet of snow out there. It's ridiculous. Get in here. You just came in. Are you seriously going out? Come on, I'm not hanging out by the door. Stupid cat. What do you think you're doing? He always thinks he wants to go out, but then he gets to the door and he's like, nope. But he's an indoor cat anyway. What do you want? What do you want, buddy? You don't want this juice? I'll set this one here for later. Okay? So my husband's at the new house painting, and this whole week has been crazy, as you heard, you know, me talking about and stuff, but one of the other things is that my car's transmission is, like, pretty much dead. We couldn't even back out of our driveway after plowing, which is pretty bad, because any car, even if you have crappy wheels, you should still have the power to be able to get out eventually. You know, you might have a few times because your tires might spin a bit, but other than that, like, any car should be able to get out, and we had just no power to even, like, back up whatsoever. So you could hear, like, the transmission, like, grinding. And so frustrated with that, because my car, it's like I do everything, like, that's how I get things done, obviously, so my husband doesn't have to do it. And it sucks too, because we're moving and I could use it for moving, and we can't now. So just have to rely on whoever can help us out. Oh, what happened? Is that a cool movie? I love you.
A kitty.
A kitty. What's his name?
This is...
Is that Pig?
Pig.
I love you, buddy.
Now.
I love you. No, you don't want to say it?
Oh, babe.
It's at home.
Home. No, not
Boov. Boov? Oh, his name's O.
O.
Thank you. because the internet guy is supposed to show up. My husband's very sick, and good thing Riker's getting over it. I am okay so far, as long as I can get through today. Even if I come down with it tomorrow, Monday at least, we'd be pretty much moved in. But I feel really bad because my husband's really sick, so I just came back here to do that, and then I'm going to try to pick up my husband's like tools and stuff because there's still all the paint and everything everywhere. Some of those paint buckets I don't know what to do with, but after that we have to like vacuum and stuff. So I can show you how the walls came out. I like them a lot. Painted the ceiling, and then we did the walls all together. I did the easy part, the rolling, but it's the fireplace. Painted that shelf, so it looks like really nice. I love it so much. And he painted all the doors. So, and then the floor in here is all dark now. It was like a weird red color with the blue walls. So it's like the office area and then possible playroom if we end up moving the office stuff in there. I thought I heard the guy. So I'll show you the dining room really quick. But things are just piling up. We'll just keep going and just doing what we can because we gotta get in here. This is the dining room. So same color, but it's just, it looks so nice. Painted that shelving too, and the floors in here are just the regular old wood floors, which are nice. So you just have to make sure you vacuum the cracks because they get pretty gross. But I already did some of that. I just gotta do more. So I'm gonna start collecting stuff, like all his paint, while I wait. And the only thing we didn't get to do is this bathroom, which I need to wash the walls because the walls are terrible. But he's gonna do that probably Sunday or a time that he has, and then the kitchen we haven't done, so that's probably going to be done too, another day. So, but there's still a lot of like stuff everywhere that needs to be fixed. But I literally jumped out of bed, I made him breakfast and a specialty to make him feel better. I brushed my teeth and put up my hair and ran out the door. So. But it's okay. Can't always look great all the time. Now I don't know what to say because I want to vlog so I don't feel alone. But there's not much to say. And the guy like comes, he's like, there's a random person talking in there, and then it comes in, it's just me. But yeah, so I'm gonna start picking up tools so that way I can get things done.
You watch my videos? I got the camera. Do you want to be on or no? You want to be on?
So I'm here with a friend of mine, Sarah. She doesn't want to be on camera, so I'm going to respect her. But we're almost done. We've done so much crazy stuff. There's Stewie.
It's okay.
No, I didn't get you. I didn't get
it's fine. No, you can
be on camera. So this is my friend,
hi,
Sarah.
She's one of my younger friends. But we're almost done for the most part. They're gonna come back for a couple more loads, but pretty much got most of the big stuff and the major stuff. Still need like our coffee.
It's been hectic. Like really hectic.
I know. I'm pretty tired. I mean, I got up at 8, which is good because I needed my sleep, but my husband's sick now. So he's been really stressed. Riker's starting to get a little funky because he doesn't quite understand what's going on. And then he's also starting to get a little sick again just because of the stress of everything. So they should be back soon. We're going to grab the rest of the stuff and then we're going to head out. And I'll probably show you more over there. I didn't quite show you the actual moving process because it was just crazy. We're just trying to get it done. We had limited time too. So, but yeah, I'll show you more over there.
Terrible.
Okay, we'll get chips. So we're at the new house. I'm just gonna find chips. Oh, I gotta find them. I don't know where Meme put them. You want that one? I think Dada wants salt vinegar chips. I gotta put this guy to bed. Brian is in bed. And we're pretty much in here. So it just feels weird because we're our friends over here. Get this guy a bath. And we're gonna call it a day.